Welcome to Mysteries and Crime. I'm your host, Melissa Thompson. Today, I wanted to talk to you about a little missing girl. She vanished on June 15th of this year. Now, I'm wondering if you guys have heard of this case. This is coming out of Tennessee, and I'm going to discuss things as they came out in the news because we've been getting drips and drabs of information. So let's start with that. Summer Moon Utah Wells is 5 years old. She vanished on June 15th of 2021 from Rogersville in Hawkins County, Tennessee. According to the police, Wells was last seen outside her home in the Beach Creek community. We'll add more to that information later on. Summer was reportedly wearing gray pants. It's been said gray pants or gray shorts and a pink shirt, and she had no shoes on. Investigators say she is 3 foot tall, weighs 40 pounds, and has blonde hair and blue eyes. Her hair may now be shorter than in some pictures being circulated around, according to the Tennessee Bureau of Investigations. Hawkins County Sheriff Ronnie Lawson said on June 16, 2021, that more than 100 people from 19 agencies are searching in the area where Wells was last seen. Authorities encourage Beach Creek residents to check any sheds, crawl spaces, or other potential hiding places, and check any trail cameras. They want you to search every nook and corner where a little girl might hide or just be staying in place for some shelter because she got lost. Police say the circumstances surrounding Summer Wells' disappearance remains unclear. Hawkins County Sheriff Lawson said, "It was too early to tell if there was any foul play involved in the toddler's disappearance," but added that family members have been cooperative. He said, quote, "We're going to continue on until we find Summer and put this case to rest." On Thursday, June 17, 2021, the Tennessee Bureau of Investigations held a briefing to discuss the latest in the ongoing search for Summer. TBI's public information officer, Leslie Earhart, started the press conference by stating, quote, "We had hoped to have good news to share with you by now, but unfortunately, we do not," end quote. We were all hoping yesterday for some good news, too. I was watching that press conference, and I felt very, very upset that this little girl is out there and they can't find her. Churchill Rescue Squad Captain Tim Koo is in charge of this rescue and search. He stated, quote, "Everyone continues to ask if she wandered off. Why did somebody not see her?" This part of the community, he said, the residents are very spread out. So those of us who live near cities and are in very dense areas, we don't understand this, like how incredibly far apart these houses are. But they are very far apart. So that could be why nobody has spotted her. Some people being from one hilltop to the other hilltop or at the start of the road, and you might go a mile before you ever get to another residence, making that very difficult for residents just to be able to be at home while outside working or something and notice her leaving that area, end quote. Who then went on to explain why they are not asking for volunteers to help in the search, stating, quote, "Due to the extreme terrain, the nature of this, trying to locate her, trained professionals are what we need at this time to make sure that these residents don't become endangered and expand this issue with having to search for somebody else," end quote. Leslie Earhart from the TBI went on to say, quote, "As we stated before, the circumstances surrounding Summer's disappearance remain unclear. If we do develop information that she was taken and we develop a suspect and a vehicle description, we will share that out immediately. At this time, that's just not the case," end quote. She said that they have received nearly 50 leads so far, but none have panned out. This was yesterday's press conference. Now, there's more updated information that I will let you know. She says, quote, "The longer this goes, the more concerned we get," end quote. Everybody knows the longer a child is missing, the worse the outcome may be, and I am praying that is not the case in this situation. Investigators have come out and confirmed that Summer's father has a criminal history because a reporter asked that in yesterday's press conference. Hawkins County Sheriff Ronnie Lawson said, quote, "Everybody's a person of interest till we find Summer," end quote. Now, AT&T and Verizon have been assisting authorities because cell reception is very bad and searchers have been having a hard time communicating back and forth. So they're trying to help with signal boosters so everybody can communicate with one another while on searching for Summer and everybody's on the same page in the search. On Wednesday, June 16th, TBI issued an Amber Alert for Summer after initially issuing an endangered child alert on Tuesday, June 15th. So they have upgraded her situation now when she was reported missing. The agency chose to upgrade the alert because of new information and growing concern. Hawkins County Sheriff Ronnie Lawson said more than 100 first responders were combing the areas near Summer's home, which is about 15 miles southwest of Kingsport. He said that area is, quote, "very dense, a hard area to search, with very little radio communication possible." The family is cooperating in the investigation, he said again, but declined to answer questions about any issues within the home. We do not know what her family life was like. He added it was too early to tell if there was any foul play involved in her disappearance. Now, let's talk about how the Amber Alert was sent out. The Amber Alert lists the following details for Summer. She is age 5, her sex is a female, race is white, hair is blonde, eyes blue. She stands at 3 feet tall, weighs 40 pounds, and the NCIC number is M as in Mary, 47627498. She is missing from Rogersville, Tennessee, and the date she went missing is June 15th of 2021. Anyone with any information on her whereabouts is asked to contact the Hawkins County Sheriff's Office at 423-272-7121 or the TBI at 1-800-TBI-FIND. Search efforts have resumed for Summer Wells this morning, that's Friday, June 18th. Dozens of first responders from more than 40 agencies are combing the hills and mountains around Ben Hill Road in northeast Tennessee, searching for Summer, who remains the subject of the statewide Amber Alert. Leslie Earhart, spokesperson for the TBI, had another press conference on Friday, and she said that they have now received 85 tips. So the tips are still coming in, which is great. And hopefully some of these pan out. Since Summer went missing, Earhart stated, quote, "We welcome information, but please don't share speculation and rumors on social media," end quote. Now the captain, Tim Koo, who is the head of the search operations, he is the captain of the rescue squad. He stated this morning, quote, "There are numerous streams and creeks, lots of ponds and holding spots for livestock that we feel are just as important to search as the rest. We want to flip every rock, check every crevice to make sure we don't miss a spot." They have added divers today to the search party, so that's why he is talking about water spots and everything. "Despite the challenging terrain, people are searching for her. And they told me," he said, "we will not stop," end quote. As of Thursday night, Koo said crews had covered 680 acres. So I'm assuming maybe tomorrow we'll find out how many more acres they have covered. And they plan to have, they're hoping to get 1,000 acres covered by tonight, Friday night. "The terrain is causing teams to be exhausted quickly," he said. Really, I have been on the rescue squad, and search parties can be very, very exhausting. Hawkins County Sheriff Ronnie Lawson said multiple searches have been conducted, but all were with consent and no search warrants have been necessary. He said, quote, everything is still on the table. We are trying to find out what happened to this young lady and we're not going to stop until we find her, end quote. Summer's father, Don Wells, spoke out finally on Friday, June 18th, about his daughter's disappearance, saying, now here, pay attention, he's going to give some extra information about her disappearance. He says, quote, she was planting flowers with her mother and her grandmother, and she wanted to go into the house. So my wife watched her go into the door, and she went into the house. And the boys were on the internet, of course, and she wanted to go downstairs and play with her toys. So when her mother came in and she says, Summer, and she went down into the basement and she didn't answer. So she went down there and she was gone. So she went out the basement door, which was unlocked, and we haven't seen her since, end quote. He said he believes his daughter may have been kidnapped. He says, quote, we know she wouldn't leave the property. She doesn't do that. End quote. And then they ask again, anyone with information on her whereabouts is asked to contact the Hawkins County Sheriff's Office at 423-272-7121 or again the TBI at 800-TBI-FIND. The Hawkins County Rescue Squad said, while they do not need volunteers right now, they do have a need for some supplies. And I can tell you from firsthand experience, this is very necessary for these men and women searching for this little girl. They made the following list. They could use beef jerky, meat sticks, Slim Jims, Little Debbie cakes, deodorant, Tylenol, ibuprofen, cooling towels, and 55-gallon trash bags. They said donations can be dropped off at either of two places, at 3711 Beach Creek Road, Rogersville, and 955 East McKinney Avenue in Rogersville. If you have any questions about anything that they may need, please contact the Logistics Section's officer, Sandra Lewis, at 413-231-4254. Now, the TBI put out a Twitter post of a memorial for Summer, and they put out a picture, and I'll have it in the video for you. And their tweet said the following, balloons and flowers have been placed in the prayer garden in honor of 5-year-old Summer Wells. The garden is located at a church near Summer's home, and they put hashtag TN Amber Alert. So this is an ongoing investigation right now, and we just don't know where this little girl is. And time is of the essence. So if you live in this area, please, please, please check your cameras, check any small crevice spot that you could think of. I know they don't want people going out because of the terrain. So if you can, please drop off the supplies. That would be so helpful to all of those folks looking for this little girl. My heart goes out to everyone looking for this little girl. She's beautiful and I hope she's found. I hope she's found safe and that she's okay and nothing sinister has happened to her. There have just been too many cases involving children, and I hope that this is not another bad situation, because we all know that the first 24 hours are crucial. So let's just hope maybe she got lost, and because there's woods all over the place. So maybe she got lost and she couldn't find her way back. Let's hope that they can cover lots of terrain and that we find her and we can bring this baby girl home. I hope all of you are well and, you know, you're keeping up with the cases. If you have any case suggestions, I'd love to hear about them. If you're looking into something, let me know. And I will see you next time. If you're listening to this on the weekend, I hope you're having an amazing weekend. And if you can, I'd love for you to join our little community. I love talking to you guys in the comments below. And be well, okay? Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.